Internationally acclaimed Bruce Munro has created a breathtaking exhibit using large-scale light-based art, and it's called Stories in Light. And here to tell us more is Angela McConnell, Montalvo Art Center's Executive Director, and Kelly Sicat, Montalvo Art Center's Residency Program Director. All right. Well, thank you so much for coming on the show. I'm excited to talk about this because I've seen some video, I've seen pictures, and the exhibit just looks beautiful.
It is beautiful, and we invite you to come. And we're excited to be here, Michelle, because your visitors should not miss this exhibit. It's absolutely breathtaking.
I'm with you on this. I am with you on this. Okay, so talk about this exhibition. It features, what, 10 artists?
So we brought Bruce Munro in. He was inspired by Montalvo, inspired by the place. He proposed 10 large-scale installations around the grounds. Some are intimate in scope, and some are very large-scale. You see there about 23,000 fiber optic strands, and they cover our entire grounds. It's really quite fabulous.
I mean, how long does it take to put this all together?
It was a six-week installation, and community members came. We had corporate partners like Applied Materials came and helped us. And the artist, as Kelly said, came to Montalvo to be in residence for a few days. And when he saw the place, he arrived at night. He lives in England. And when he walked up the hill to see the vision of our gorgeous 107-year-old historic villa, he was transported back to when he was a child, and he had this love and affinity for the author C.S. Lewis and the books, The Chronicles of Narnia. And he said that he had to create an exhibition based around that theme. And so this exhibition is so special because it's the first time this artist is making an exhibition around one single theme. Mm-hmm. It's the West Coast premiere of his work, so you can't see Bruce Munro anywhere on the West Coast. And in this installation, there are four works that have never been seen, and they've been created for Montalvo. So you have to come and see
it. And it's for everybody. I mean, you talk about C.S. Lewis, so you're talking kids
Absolutely.
And adults and everyone. What I love about this, it's not like an art museum where you go and you look at art on
right.
a wall. You're immersed in it.
That's right. It really is a special place. And we have all these wonderful stories. We had a woman come from Pebble Beach to celebrate her 90th birthday at the exhibition. We've had marriage proposals, about four of them. It really is a place, and the artist has said that he hopes that it is a place for people to come and be kind to themselves and to others. He's a really special person, very deeply compassionate. And that's what we hope. We hope that people will come and unplug at Montalvo.
Why do you think this kind of art brings, because it is different. I mean, you know, you're using light in different
right.
spaces. Why do you think it's so appealing to so many people?
Well, for one, it's accessible, right? It doesn't need interpretation. It's incredibly beautiful. And you're gonna see lights in trees, in the ground, inside the house, and you really feel it's this magical experience, I think.
Let's talk more about some of these other artists who were a part
this is
of this.
Great. Yeah. Well, Bruce Munro came in. He spent time in our residency, so he is the premier artist working on it. We brought in a team to help install the works around the grounds, but it was really his vision. And going back to this childhood love of Narnia, thinking about the place and the magical sort of qualities of Montalvo, if you've never been, you come there and the world changes a little bit. It slows a little bit. And he wanted to make these special works that created passages, portals into other kinds of conversations around transitions in life.
Did he work his art into the, I guess, the barriers of, or the confines of Montalvo, or did Montalvo kind of help him?
He came to us, he spent time on the grounds, and he came to us with a proposal. He's a master of space. He's a master of light and a master of space, and he's really knew how to transform our gardens and transform the spaces so that they would be immersive, so that they would capture the imagination and transport our visitors.
Well, it certainly does just from that video, so I can't wait to see it in person. It's absolutely beautiful. Thank you so much for coming on the show.
It's a pleasure to be here.
Yeah,
it's
yeah.
be great.
Hope you'll come.
And do not miss Bruce Munro, right?
Right.
You can't do
closes
that at Montalvo.
March 17th.
March 17th, all right. Stories in Light, the exhibit closes March 17th, like we just said. So there are just a few days left to go and see it, so please do so. For more information, just go to montalvoarts.org. Coming up, intuitive counseling when we come back.